What is up, everybody? It's 7 a.m. here in Chelsea. I'm at Hank's. I'm gonna go for a quick early morning run and then get my day started. Today is going to be filled with unexpected surprises and also many things to get done. I just discovered this morning that the John Hanifin Band is having an album release party at the Burren at 7 p.m., so I'm super stoked. There just might be a couple of clips of me hanging out with the band and doing some filming for them tonight.
You really want me to care? All that beeswax up in my ear, saying sweet nothing I don't want to hear. Like I heard, she heard, they heard, but y'all heard a lot of bull that ain't worth my time. And I read my zodiac sign that told me that people are gonna tempt the old me.
Before people moved into the area of Chelsea and families from all over the world moved into this town, Chelsea was known to be just this really great, beautiful, vast space of nature. And it's been destroyed pretty much. It barely remains. The Chelsea Mill Creek is now a joke because of all the littering that continues here and pollution. Plus there's Route 16 right beside it. And I really want to do something special. I'm feeling really passionate about this. I'm looking around at this space and it is disgusting. There is trash everywhere. I'm thinking maybe I can get a group of volunteers to come out here with me and we can clean this place up, because the Mill Creek is a very special place for all Chelsea residents, and it would be a really great way to volunteer and give back to the community while also taking care of our environment and protecting nature. So what do you guys think? Who's gonna come out here and clean this up with me?
Damn, if I let anybody control me, you would know if you only know me, how hard it was to stop defending myself from what they say, judging me and the choices I made. But no one can let my life but me, so you should be grateful you're lucky, ho. Then you ain't gotta deal with the feelings I feel through, and I ain't gotta deal with you. We even. Get your feelings off. Get your feelings off me, cause I ain't trying to feel what you want me to. Ain't trying.
Session at the skate park was great. I learned switch ollie. I started working on my switch kickflip. I learned front nose slide, and I made a bunch of great friends. I filmed some really great skaters. Now I'm at Bunker Hill for the music club. And I ran into an old friend of mine from campus. His name is Mike Aquino, and we had a great discussion about his plans moving forward. You know, he has a business plan, and he would like to propose to the city of Malden to open a business. And we, you know, we sat down and we talked about the difference between nonprofit and for-profit organizations. I gave them some of my knowledge about what I know about the difference. You know, working, I have some experience working with nonprofit organizations, so I gave him my 2 cents, and I think it really helped him, and it was great hearing from him because he seems really ambitious and passionate about this project. He wants to open up like a building where he can invite community members to come and pay like a daily or monthly fee to come in and just kind of hang out, lounge out, have a place with great Wi-Fi, you know, video games in one room, couches in another room, you know, a pool table in another room or whatever. You know, just basically like an entertainment place in Malden. And I think it's a great idea. However, it could be a little bit tricky in Malden because there already are a couple of organizations that do that. I'm not sure if they're nonprofit or for-profit, but there is the Teen Center on Main Street, and there is also this other place called Bodaborg on Pleasant Street, right next door to where he would like to open up his organization. So we talked about that, and it was a really interesting conversation. Also, the music club meeting was freaking fantastic. It was so productive. We talked about a number of projects, and it was just really great. So I'm really feeling good about that moving forward. The next part of my day is I go to Malden, and I get rid of some more stuff in my room because I am moving, and I have to get rid of a bunch of my stuff, purge some of my belongings, as Hank would say. Then head to my rehearsal space because I would like to work on my chords, and I'm also giving Felicia a drum lesson at 5:30, and it is now 3 o'clock, so I don't have much time between now and this lesson. So I did not hear back from the John Hanifin Band. So I just went upon myself to show up and come record their set, and hopefully they needed a filmer.
That's the most angry we're gonna get. Don't walk too close to the soundboard. You ever see those polar bear attacks when people were like, oh, so cute? That's George. You already gave your money to Tom, so he's fine. About this time last year, we recorded an album, and we didn't release it.
Why? I don't know.
Oh, it's because it sounded awful. Because we did it with this really big guy that had all this really nice gear, and then we heard it and was like, oh, he's on drugs. And we just ended up recording this new EP, which we're really excited about because we brought in different producers from different parts of the world, and that will actually be out Halloween. More importantly, let's talk about me. I like walks on the beach. I enjoy coconut oil. Actually, no, I don't. There's nothing about coconuts I like, but the one thing that I do like about even then there's Irish Spring, baby. Hop in the shower, bathe yourself. That's what it's, you know, the swap on Friday. Happy birthday to you. Anyways, that second song we call is called Kim with Kindness because I was bullied a lot in school, and my mother this one time said, kill him with kindness, so I said, fine. So I actually wrote a really nice card and then cut my friend. This next song is about a girl that I just really needed to get rid of. That's why we call him the Lead Foot Giant.
Let's get up for the new people that came in.
Woo!
Yeah, there you go. Welcome to the park. All we need is your social security mailing address.
It's okay, I own the mic. Quick shout out to my sponsors at NS Design. They're amazing people. Ned Steinberger, I don't know if you are all aware, but the headless stock that Van Halen plays is the guitar that's designed by Ned. And I called them 3 years ago and I had the idea of this project and I was like, hey, you should give me a cello. And they're like, who are you? I'm like, I don't know yet. But it might work out. And if it does, you don't want Yamaha on it. And like 2 weeks later, I had a cello.
Which is, so I used to be a little bit thick
back in the day, when I was walking to school as opposed to taking an Uber. Maurizio said to me, he was like, you know, John, I really like what you're doing with the graphic designing, but maybe I could try it out. And then he showed me the first draft, and I was like, asshole. So much better than me. When I met Maurizio, I didn't look too good. I just got out of a relationship. And actually, most of my songs aren't about girls, I'm talking about them because it's relatable, right? Anyways, so he said, wow, you don't really look that good. And I said, oh, well, I just got out of a relationship. And you know, Maurizio's Brazilian. And I said, I just got out of a relationship. And he said, oh, you know, who was it? And I said, well, she was Brazilian. And he just looked at me like dead in the face and went, ho. And that was the end of the conversation. I didn't have to elaborate on anything. That was it. He completely understood. But what's funny about this Brazilian girl, she abandoned me in Calgary, Canada.
What?
Yeah, this is great. We got an argument. And then we got in this argument, and she abandoned me. And I thought she would come back, so I was standing there all proud. And after an hour, I was like, I'm actually in trouble. Now I'm in trouble. So I got on the train, and I asked, like, where are the Rocky Mountains? You're in Calgary, and they were like, go that way. Is it okay? So I get on the train, and then I started to kind of remember where driving from her place into Calgary was. I got off the train, and there were some really nice people at the Shell gas station, like 75 of them. I swear to God, it was like a stand-up comedy night. I had like all of them surrounding me around the pumps. And I was like, no, you wouldn't believe it. This girl treats me so badly.
Now, do you see why I can't mount to the Burren tonight? Come on. You can't miss a set like that. John's comedy demands hilarious. If you want the full set, just go to the video description. You'll find the full set down. Make sure you subscribe to that channel too. Aside from the vlogging, there's the full live performances. Straight from Boston, 617. Check it out. Have a good night. I was supposed to end the video at the last clip, but you see, I actually met two musicians soon after that last clip. One of them, her name is Juliana. Another one is a singer-songwriter, guitar player, and his name is Joe Nicholson. My skateboard's probably cutting into this microphone. But amazing people. They just invited me to a jam session gathering at the North End tomorrow. The power of networking is incredible, people. Get out there, meet people, and just have a passion for socializing and meeting people. Like, step outside your comfort zone and meet people. It's the best feeling ever to find people of all backgrounds and just share your life with them. Share commonalities, share differences. I'm feeling so great. This is probably the best time of my life.